Welcome back to Movies Recapped. Today I will show you a sports drama film from 2014, called Draft Day. Warning, spoilers ahead. Watch out and enjoy. With just over 12 hours on a clock, it ticks down, counting down towards the start of the 2014 NFL Draft. We watch as the hall that will house the draft is being set up and a voiceover explains the importance and excitement of Draft Day. At 4:15 a.m. in Seattle, a man answers his work phone. He and his colleagues must decide what they're going to do with their number one pick. Should they keep it and take top quarterback prospect Bo Callahan, or should they play the long game and trade their number one slot for something that will benefit them for years? They say that they would be stupid to pass up Callahan, and if they did, the city would be furious with them. The only way they could possibly get away with trading their number one spot would be to get something huge in return. They'd have to trade with someone that's desperate. Cut to Cleveland and the manager of the Browns, Sonny Weaver Jr. His father just happens to have been the former coach for the team, passed away recently. The two had a bit of a contentious relationship as Sonny Jr. fired Sonny Sr. from his coaching post. In addition to the stress of losing a father, Sonny also has the stress of becoming one. His semi-secret girlfriend and the Browns' salary cap analyst, Allie Parker, is pregnant. As she is leaving Sonny's house after giving him this news, his phone rings with an opportunity from Seattle. The Seahawks' general manager, Tom Michaels, offers to trade their first pick in the draft for the Browns' first-round draft pick for this season and then the following 2 years. Sonny turns him down out of loyalty to his current quarterback, Brian Drew, despite him spending much of the last season injured. Sonny gets a series of phone calls from prospects that are eligible to be drafted that evening, including Vontae Mack, a linebacker from Ohio State, and Ray Jennings, son of Hall of Famer and Browns legend, Earl Jennings. These calls don't leave Sonny with any more confidence about his decisions that he will soon have to make. He then meets with the owner of the Browns, Anthony Molina. Molina tells Sonny to make a splash, or he runs the risk of losing his job. He tells him that they need a new quarterback if they want to have any shot of winning, and the only quarterback worth getting this year is Callahan. This conversation prompts Sonny to call Seattle back and take the deal. When he breaks this news to his office staff, their reactions are split. Some are thrilled at the idea of getting Callahan, while others are very against the idea of getting rid of Drew since he is so highly respected. They are especially upset with him when they learn the cost of getting the number one pick. However, during the office's discussions, Molina calls, somehow already aware of the news. He congratulates Sonny on his maneuverings, and is ecstatic that they will get Callahan. Sonny himself is still not convinced that Callahan is the best choice. The Browns were in no position to consider that they might get him, and so had not fully examined him before. Sonny says that digging deep into the young man is the only way that he can feel good about choosing him over Mack and Jennings. Bitter about not getting picked in the number 7 spot, Mack reveals the trade on Twitter. This causes an uproar in the football world. All the projections that teams had been working on for months have now gone out the window and there's less than 10 hours to come up with a new plan. Sonny calls Mack about his tweet, and during the call Mack tells Sonny to rewatch the college plays between Mack and Callahan. Callahan's team may have won over Mack's, but Mack beat Callahan every time. This gives Sonny even more doubts about possibly choosing Callahan and his ability to perform under pressure. These doubts are expanded upon when he finds out that Drew has fully recovered from his injury last season, and is in better shape than ever. Drew is furious that his hard work in getting healthy will have been for nothing. Several other key players on the Browns team back him up on this. This threat from Drew causes even more of a divide amongst fans in the front office and leads Sonny to stress about this decision even more. The coach for the Browns, Vince Penn, approaches Allie about everything that has transpired so far during draft day. He asks her to talk to Sonny since he'll listen to her. He doesn't think that Callahan is a bad player, quite the opposite, but what he doesn't like doing is working with rookie quarterbacks. He says they need a lot of training on how to perform at the professional level. That's something that he doesn't want to deal with on top of coaching the rest of the team. Despite his best efforts, Allie tells him that she won't talk to Sonny about this. Finally, after hours of digging into Callahan's past, the Browns find something that might be an issue. He and some friends went out to a restaurant for his 21st birthday party. Some of his fans found out where he was celebrating and things got out of hand. The police were called but no charges were put on Callahan. They did take down everyone's name that was there though, and what the Browns front office discovered was that none of Callahan's teammates were there. Now why wouldn't even one of them have shown up to celebrate the star player's birthday? Sonny calls the coach from Callahan's alma mater and asks him about the young man. He gets rather defensive about the manner, leaving Sonny just as conflicted as ever. His decision is not made any easier when he gets a phone call from the front office of the Buffalo Bills. They offer to make another deal that further divides the Browns office. Sonny takes his frustrations and questions to Allie. She tells him that he knows what he should do, even if he doesn't realize it yet. He leaves her office with his decision. It's a yes for Callahan, and a no for Buffalo. As usual, Penn disagrees with this move. To try and convince Penn, and himself, Sonny once again has them play footage from the game that Callahan and Mac face off. Every time Callahan was sacked, he made stupid mistakes in the next play, just as Mac implied they would find. It turns out that the Browns were able to dig up a little more on Callahan, this time showing that he has no problem lying to his superiors. Adding to Sonny's stress of the day, his mother and ex-wife show up to his office unannounced. The reading of his father's will was earlier in the day and they came to scatter his ashes across the Browns' practice field as Sonny reads a prayer, just as he wished. Sonny Jr. is angry that they would come to do this today of all days and ask why they can't just come back tomorrow to do it. Allie overhears the heated conversation and comes to see what is going on. Sonny's mother storms out and says that if he won't help her and follow his father's wishes, then she'll just do it herself. Sonny and Allie take a walk outside to get some fresh air and let him cool off after the altercation. It is on the practice field that was named after his father that he reveals to her that he never hated the man. He explains that the reason he fired the old man was because his mother begged him to. The doctors told Sonny Sr. that his heart condition needed him to reduce stress, and that his job as coach was the thing that caused him the most stress. His dad, though, refused to quit. He loved the team and job too much. Although he didn't want to do it, Sonny Jr. listened to his mother and fired him. He wanted to give her as much time with his father as possible. Sonny Jr. took one step further to help his mother and made it look like he fired the old man out of jealousy, otherwise he was afraid that Sonny Sr. might grow to resent his wife. With less than an hour before the draft is set to start, Sonny can't shake his feeling from before, and calls Callahan to ask him about his 21st birthday. Callahan tells him that he wishes he could answer if his teammates were there, but he doesn't remember a thing about that night. Sonny hangs up the call and it is clear that he worries that this was just another lie from the young man. Sonny looks out the window of his office and sees his mother, still standing on the 50-yard line, thinking about and missing her husband. Finally, after nearly 13 hours of debating what to do, it is time for the draft to begin. Still unsure what the right decision is, Sonny agonizes over the decision alone in his office. He comes to his decision and sends it to New York, where all the festivities are happening. He then goes to join the rest of his office and watch as the world finds out that he chose Vontae Mack as his first pick. The announcement of this selection shocks fans and rocks many of the plans that other teams had for their first pick. Everyone anticipated that Callahan would get drafted in the number one slot, so no one planned to have him as an option. Furious that Sonny didn't choose Callahan, Molina leaves the draft festivities and flies back to Cleveland, fully prepared to fire him. Penn is also irate and threatens to resign. Worried about why the Browns would drop a player that seems like a sure thing, many other teams skip over Callahan as well. The Seahawks, however, now picking the Browns' original seventh spot, are still planning to take him. Sonny, though, sees a chance. The sixth-round pick belongs to the Jacksonville Jaguars, who have a rookie manager. Sonny calls them and convinces the newbie to trade this pick for the Browns' second pick for this year and the following two seasons. Sonny then calls Seattle and says that since he passed on Callahan, their deal is off. He asks for his original picks back, along with player David Putney. Eventually, Seattle takes this deal, and that leaves them with Jacksonville's original number 6 pick. The Seahawks use this to snatch up Callahan and for $7 million less than they had originally budgeted him for. Back with their original number 7 pick, the Browns take this chance to get back on Molina and Penn's good sides and pick Ray Jennings, the son of Earl Jennings, a famed former Browns player. The office team celebrates a hugely successful draft year for the Browns. During the after-party Sonny and his mother make up, they both realize that it has been an immensely stressful week for the other. She tells Sonny that his father would be proud, and Sonny tells her that she will soon become a grandmother. Flash forward to the first game of the season. Sonny and Allie have gone public with their relationship and she is several months into her pregnancy. They walk into the VIP booth as the next generation of Browns take the field. Make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.